want to congratulate the Advantage Maharashtra Expo 2017 organizers for organizing the expo in Aurangabad. My association with Aurangabad is very old. I remember as the chairman of Sarasvat Bank, I used to be there so often, and I think Aurangabad is like my second home. I had hundreds or even thousands of friends in the city with whom I would have loved to meet if I was there physically to meet all of you. But unfortunately, I'm not able to join you. So my apologies, as well as something which I lost, is lost to me. As we know, Maharashtra is already the most developed state in the country, which has a very dynamic chief minister who is looking forward to making Maharashtra even more developed than what it is today. We have a number of new initiatives taken, and we are investing huge amount of money into infrastructure of the state. I don't think there is any other state comparable to Maharashtra which is making so much investment in infrastructure. And as we know, infrastructure investment today brings in immediate growth for today, because whatever you invest, job creation happens, demand for steel, cement, and everything goes up, manufacturing increases. But that infrastructure is a launching pad for tomorrow's development. So what is happening today will benefit Maharashtra today, but will benefit for all times to come. So now, if I were to look at the future of Maharashtra, I can say another several decades, you will see Maharashtra growing at a much faster rate because of the action taken today. And what is the infrastructure? Only the other day when the Prime Minister was in Mumbai, only for one city we had decided to invest 1,06,000 crores. 55,000 crores of railway projects alone. For rest of Maharashtra, 22,000 crores of new projects we announced as a joint venture with the state government. In addition to almost 57,000 crores of projects which are already going on for the railways alone. We are trying to invest money into roads, which Mr. Nitin Gadkari is trying to do. We are trying to invest money into power. We are trying to invest money into water. And a very innovative idea that Prime Minister, the Chief Minister did was to have Jal Shivir, where the local initiative, small little investment, has created so much of abundant availability of water, which in turn will not only benefit water, but also help the livestock, which will help the agriculture, which will again create more income for the farmers coming from agriculture and allied resources. So this is a great game changer that is happening in Maharashtra. Maharashtra has a great potential, Konkan with 720 kilometers of coastline, with huge possibility of ports. Again, as the railways, we are connecting ports with hinterland. We already started two port connectivity projects. Jaigarh is already started. Then we are also linking south Maharashtra, that is Konkan, to western Maharashtra by Karad Chipurun project. We are also starting something in, so Maharashtra, Konkan can be a great potential for tourism. Sindhudurga is the only district in Maharashtra, or in the state, in the country, sorry, which is a tourism district. And when was it declared in 1996, the year I became member of parliament, the first thing as a member of parliament was to get this district declared as a tourism district. We have Vidarbha, great potential for cotton growing. Oranges are world famous. Heart of India. Nagpur is so well located, centrally located, it's the heart of India. In fact, we are now preparing a new railway development plan for 2050, but will be started 2030 onwards. First time in India's history with spoke and hub in Nagpur. So Vidarbha has a potential of a different kind. Marathwada, again a huge potential. Western Maharashtra already developed industry-wise, cooperative-wise, milk production, entrepreneurship. So each of the four regions of Maharashtra, Marathwada, Vidarbha, Kokan, Western Maharashtra has all potential. And then we are fortunate to have India's commercial capital in Maharashtra, Mumbai. We are one of the most industrialized cities in the country. Pune is in Maharashtra. Aurangabad, another place where you are all meeting, is one of the fastest growing city. There was only one industry share, Waluj. Now there are a few more. Sidco has done development, very close to one of the world famous heritage sites, Ellora and others. So you can imagine the potential of the state of Maharashtra. Maharashtra has a significant possibilities of changing the profile of India. And therefore, we must work very closely. This expo will offer a great opportunity. We look forward to this, not only the expo succeeding, but all of you succeed in realizing this huge potential of the state of Maharashtra, which is now made possible by a very prominent leadership of Mr. Devendra Fadnis. Our Prime Minister has spelled out a clear vision for India. He is working for developed India, for corruption-free India, India in which making business will be hassle-free, which will promote entrepreneurship, which will avoid black money creation, which will create new opportunities for youth of India by skilling India and others, which will also create manufacturing facilities in India by making India. So I am very happy that there is a leader of Narendra Modi ruling India, trying to work on many issues, very ably supported by Chief Minister of Maharashtra, my good friend Mr. Devendra Fadnis. And therefore, you are very lucky to have such a great place to have this expo. When India is progressing, Maharashtra is driving at a faster rate, and you are all here to find out how best you can contribute to it. So let me offer you best wishes, great support, and any good idea that you feel I can follow up, I'll be very happy to do that. Jai Hind, Jai Maharashtra.